Welcome back, it is Thursday and that means acting analysis for animators. And today we're gonna take a look at the last episode, it's episode 5 of Chernobyl. Today is all about details. Those are the tiny little things that I loved where you might have an eye roll or go, really? But these are the things that I thought that was cool and this was cool. So lots of tiny little things that may or may not be important, but I wanna go through them now. So let's not waste time. Let's do a quick fire, go through all those little tiny little scenes. First up is this one with the dad and the little kid on top. And what I liked about this is that the kid holds on to the ears. It's a tiny thing, but I think it's super cute. I can see my little one doing this, and I thought this was a cute little detail. Instead of just having hands down or maybe holding on to something else, it's very specific. I'm holding on to those ears, and I thought that was super cute. Next up is this one where he asks him, wait, was there a problem? He interrupts him and says, wait, are you going to ask me if there was a problem? Can't you read my face? And after he says that, look at his reaction. It's this cascading, it's tiny, it's subtle, but it's great. I mean, not that this is subtle, but I love that. First, he deflates, like, oh, I did something wrong again. Then he has that little, so shoulder first, exhale, tiny things in the mouth, the head turns a little bit, then a little bit more, look at that, lip compression, and then the head goes down. So good, let's watch that again. It's just such a good reaction. And as always, it goes into something where this is your lip sync, the lip sync is done, you can still continue and then show a person reacting to this. Of course, he's always kind of the stoic, he doesn't react at all, but more about him later. Next up is this where she tells him, or she asks him that he should tell the truth. Why do I show this? I liked this part. Bring her hand up here. She can't get too close, she can't really touch him, but it's more of a personal request almost, like you should go and say the truth and sacrifice even more. But the thing is always, animation is always, to me at least, there's a lot of hand gesturing, arm gesturing, and always seems a bit too much. And this is just there to make it a bit more personal. If she would say the same thing, leaning back and maybe, you know, hiding her arms, it wouldn't be as personal. It wouldn't be as almost intimate, I would say intimate, but it's just something where I'm pleading and I wanna be just a bit more personal and a bit more engaged with the person, and I'm gonna bring up my hand and leave it there. It's a tiny thing, but I just love that little moment there. And within the same sequence, she brings up two piles. This is the person that survived, and this is the pile of people that died. Now she tells him what happened, what they did, and what they sacrificed. And as he listens, this is what I wanna show you, is look at his face, the clenchingness, everything. He listens to this and is ready to just burst out, well, you know, I got there and I got contaminated, I'm gonna die too. And right there, he says it right after she's done talking. So you can see in his face, he's listening, he's tensing up, he's waiting, there's more clenching, and he waits. You can see this, it's very, very subtle, but he has that little lip raise, that little compression there, that tension. He's just ready to say it, and oh, you can see this here with the lining nicely caught here, the clenching, and bam, and then he says it. So when you do have lip sync and a character is listening to someone else, think about that acting is reacting. So as this person who's off screen or maybe over the shoulder, whatever, is talking, make sure that your character, we see the face, is really listening and reacting. And you can have a really long anticipation to that outburst, not outburst, but you know, his stronger reaction right there. This is one of those things that probably you'll just shake your head, but I like this. I liked how he drops the paper. He prepares it, right? Puts it all together, and he could just drop it. If you would animate this, you would think about the constraints. I gotta bring my arm down, open the fingers, and put that piece of paper there, and then let go. But what I like is that how he does it. He holds it, and he opens both hands, and just lets it drop. Bloop, and then puts the fingers on there, the hands on there. I know it's tiny, you're probably going, really, JD, really? But I like this, I like that just tiny detail right there. So if you do something where you let go of a prop, as always, think about how you let go of the prop, how original and how creative could it be? You might argue, well, this is twins, you got two things going at the same time. I know, but it's an interesting tiny detail that I liked. Like I said, quick fire of stuff that maybe only I like. Last time we talked about the soldiers walking and holding their guns in a different position or their rifles, and I wanna look at that sad face. He's always kinda angry, he's even challenging the court at one point, and he is always kinda looking down, in a very, very sad expression. So if you have multiple characters, like I said last time, think about contrast, even if it's subtle. And again, you might argue this is very subtle here. This is a bit more clear with the head looking down. But throughout this sequence, they always look and sit in a different way. It's very contrasting. So tiny thing, but think about that. If you have multiple characters, what is the detail? This is not really animation related, but now that it's his turn, and as we saw before in that previous sequence, but I talked about where she asked him to tell the truth, you know, he's nervous, and it's what I liked here is that little subtle thing of, hey, it's also slightly in slow motion, but look at for the head and look at the background. The camera, like, everything's kind of tracking his face, and you can see how the face kind of locks and the background kind of starts swaying right there. You can see this. Usually when that happens, the character who's locked in post gets all blurry, because technically that camera would be moving, that would be handheld. That means that this character, whatever's in the front of the lens here, would be blurred out. But because we're tracking and we're stabilizing and focusing on this, he gets a bit blurry and everything gets kind of weird as it moves. And to me, it seems like this is kind of to emphasize that moment in his head, the awkwardness, the nervousness, just that weird moment. And boom, you can see here, the camera relaxes again. I'm gonna play this again. I hope you can see this with, you know, my compression and through YouTube, but right through there, you can see how there's very clear head tracking going on. And I thought it's kind of an interesting thing of emphasizing that moment of, you know, now he has to tell the truth. Again, nothing really animation related, but I wanted to point that out. And this is something where I'm not sure what that means, but I just wanted to point it out. When I was watching this, I just noticed that he holds his tie. But is he? Is he maybe trying to keep the tie from dangling so it doesn't obstruct this? Is this something unconscious that he did? Is it something to be a bit more regal? Maybe at that point the actor ate something weird and he's just holding his stomach. Like, I have no idea. But I thought it was an interesting thing of he could dangle his arm, but he could also hold it here. But why is it having, why does he have the hand there? Is it, again, to keep maybe this from moving around too much so he's a bit more proper in front of the court? Like, I don't know, because he's also moving over and potentially leaning. So that means the tie would be here again, maybe obstructing the view or not being clean enough. I don't really have an answer, but I thought that was an interesting thing. So if I ever have a character that has a tie that is pointing at things, I'm going to remember this and think about, maybe I can do that as a pose. During his proceedings, they also go outside, and the other character we just talked about talks to him and tells him that he was actually very, very, he thinks he's not that important to this whole thing, and he's a person that won't be remembered in the history of all this. And he just told him, no, you're extremely important to this. And he has that look. He realizes maybe it was not all for nothing, because that's what he tells him. He thinks that it's all for nothing. Why am I showing you this? Because as they come back, it's interesting to me how long he looks at him. Again, this might be tricky for you to do. Hold on. Is this person looking into the camera? Maybe, maybe not. But anyway, let's go back. Let's look at him looking at him for how long. This is, again, something tricky in animation. Would you put that in there? I just thought it's an interesting, it's a very distinct thing of, I'm gonna look at him as long as I can before I sit down. Maybe this is the beginning of your shot. Let's just pretend you have two characters walking and he looks and then sits down, and maybe then your lip sync starts and he says something. Maybe he says something about him. Maybe this is a look of, I'm gonna challenge you. Maybe this is a look of, I'm worried about you. I hope you're okay. Or it's just a look of, that was weird what he did. And then he starts his thing. So again, it's not very something specific that you could use in your shot, but I thought it was interesting as potentially a beginning of a shot, or maybe an end of a shot that you have. But I'm always very interested in eyeline and eye darts or no darts, blinks, no blinks. How long do you look at a character and why? Why do you keep staring? What does that mean? And what does that mean for the audience? There's something interesting to look at, and something that I want to pay attention to in my future shots. And of course, if you watch my channel, you know I'm a big fan of swallows, and he swallows right there. Why am I showing you this? He tells the court that there was a fatal flaw. He tells them, well, when you push that button, something happens. And that's something that was hidden and he didn't know. And you can see he's always kind of angry looking and challenging or not interested. You can see this here, kind of like, this is gonna kill me. And now you have that look of what? And a blink. For the first time, he actually really blinks and takes that in and realizes, wait, what? And then you have that moment of the swallow. Just an interesting moment, especially for him. It's kind of a contrasting thing where he never seems that nervous or realizing that something bad happened. You know what I mean? Like, he's always very arrogant. He's always more in this kind of angry look or mode here. So for him to then do that blink and that swallow, it's very interesting. But again, criminally underused shape in animation. And actually, staying with this character, he tells the court what the end power was, right? It shows how this goes up and how much the reactor was operating at, and you know, just leading up to the explosion. And he says that number from, I can't remember, like 3,000 to 32,000 or something like this. And I loved the cut to his face looking. Again, is that helpful to you? Probably not, but sometimes it's interesting when you have a lot of stuff going on and then it cuts to nothing. A character just staring, or maybe it's a lot of action and then no action. There's a scene in Tangled that does that. It's very common where you have a lot of action, then it cuts to something that's very still, but it's that still moment where someone might just stare that is the big contrast that makes potentially a scene more dramatic or funnier. So like Dahlia looks over, totally hunched over, completely in shock. But anyway, this might just be me. And ending this with this scene where he talks about that we lie and lie and lie, and those lies, they're always there even though we think that we can ignore them. And if you play this, I'm gonna play just the sound with it. I might get a copyright strike here, but I'm gonna play this.
When the truth offends, we lie and lie until we can no longer remember it is even there, but it is still there.
And I love this. After all of this that he said, again, this is probably not what I'm reading into, but I love that after everything he says about lies and how it's all gonna come back to us, and he has that pause, at that moment, this comes in, the stacks of red. These are all the lies, and it's gonna lead to this, and it's gonna lead to this catastrophe because of all the lies. And then he continues.
Every lie we tell incurs a debt to the truth. Sooner or later, that debt is paid.
Such a good line, just love that moment. Again, I'm probably just reading into this, but I thought it was a cool moment of after saying all of this, the visuals of this comes back into frame, right? Right as he doesn't talk, it's almost like you wanna have, you focus on this person because they're talking, they're not talking, we go over there so we can focus on this, and then he goes and talks again and we can go back to this. I'm probably just reading into this, but I thought this was pretty cool, at least in my mind. Boom! Quick fire, rapid fire moment. We're ending this Chernobyl series with episode 5 and all those tiny little bits that I like. You're probably going, really? But maybe not. Maybe you agreed. Maybe you have other tiny little moments that you liked. As always, the comments are open. You can let me know what you liked, what you disliked. I'm very curious who else watched this and thought it was cool, and what the little things that you picked up on that were cool to you. So, no more Chernobyl. I'm going to continue with movies and other TV shows. I'm going to talk about Us. I'm going to talk about The Orville, Barry. There's more ER. I just watched Killing Eve. There's a lot of stuff to come. So, if you want to get notified about all this, you know this whole thing at the end. Subscribe, hit that bell button to get all the notifications. And if you thought that any of this was interesting and helpful and you want to put that into your own shots, I do have workshops, link in the description. You can sign up and I can talk about that stuff with your shots, and we can go through your shots and critique them and all that good stuff. So more information in the description. My workshops are always open. You can sign up at any time and start at any time. And that is it. And if you're still watching and this is the very end of the clip, you're very patient, and I appreciate that you are watching until the very end. So thank you, and I will see you next week, maybe even tomorrow if you decide to tune in.